Let's talk about the windlass system. You would normally operate the windlass system from up here in the bow compartment. There is an emergency rocker switch at the driver's dash that you would use in an emergency situation. That would be when the weather conditions or the sea conditions were such that it would be unsafe to be up here to use it. But the best windlass there is, none of them are trouble-free. So you want to be up here to monitor it as it's running, either out or in. So you would come up here, open your anchor locker lid, and the first thing you're going to do is you're going to release the safety lanyard. This lanyard is there to prevent accidental lowering of the anchor when you don't want it to. This prevents the anchor from coming out when something fails or someone accidentally lowers it when you don't want them to. This particular boat is set up with the chain counter and the remote operating system rather than switches. But either way, the system works pretty much the same. With the chain counter option, you can tell exactly how much you have let out, which is really a great thing to know based on how much depth you're dealing with. So it becomes very, very handy. It also is a very safe way to let out chain because you don't ever have to let out more than what you need. It also is great for retracting because it will tell you how much chain you've got out and how much more you have to retract before the anchor comes back into its housing on the front of the boat. Once you have pulled the anchor back in, then you always want to reinstall the safety lanyard. That is extremely important and something you always want to do. Once you've got that lanyard installed, your anchor completely housed, you just put all of this stuff back in the basket where it goes, hang up your chain counter controller, close it up, and off you go. Anchoring your A36 is really pretty easy and it'll become second nature to you pretty quickly. The big thing you got to take into consideration is what is the bottom of the lake or river, whatever, wherever you're anchored, what is it? Please rely on your dealer to give you that information because every lake is a little different. If it's sand versus rock, it takes a different amount of chain or road out than it would be if it were just sand. This boat comes with 125 feet of chain, so you can anchor in some very deep water if need be. Normally, you're probably going to be anchoring 30, 40 feet, something like that. The beauty of the chain is you don't have to have but about half the road that you would if you had chain and line. So it's a big plus. But do rely on your dealer to get you the right information regarding where you're going to be anchoring and how much chain you should be letting out in a given amount of water. Thanks for your time and watching this video. Please don't forget that your Cobalt dealer is the expert and is always available to you to answer any questions that might come up in the future. From all of us at Cobalt, thank you for your business and enjoy the water.